Alright, what's going on, boys? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, hit that like button and subscribe. We're about to be go hitting a nasty back day today. Gonna hit some deadlifts and have a really good workout. But also, guys, if you're looking at the shirt and wondering where it is, this is the next Aesthetic Boy drop. We are dropping on 420, boys. So, got the pump cover tee, Medusa. This is Justin's tattoo. There it is. Look at that. And then look at the back, boys.
Look at the back. You got the whole different perspective of the Medusa. You got the puff. This is puff printing, by the way, on the Aesthetic Boys.
Get really close on there.
Get really detailed on that.
Yeah. You can kind of see the 3D.
This is coming off the shirt. You got to get dice or die trying. This is actually a quote from Medusa.
It's fucking fire. And then this is the hoodie. Can't really.
In the light. Go this way.
Sheesh.
Then get a full turn. Look at the back, boys.
Embroidered front. Got the back.
Third eye. Atlas. The world is yours. Skeleton hands. And if you guys do recognize that image, that is on my leg right here. Obviously, I'm wearing pants, but you'll see it later on. So yeah, we got kind of both of our tattoos incorporated on it. We got his Medusa, my Atlas tattoo. And then, boys, take a look over at the stringer. Get diced or die trying. These are the Greek lettering for each letter for the brand.
It's like a hybrid. It's like a rib tank and stringer mix.
The fit is phenomenal. It's not like you said, it's like a hybrid of both. It's almost like a rib tank. It's just, it's money. It is awesome for the workouts. And then, guys, the shorts.
So we're going, obviously, with the Greek kind of theme. So we put the fucking skull right on a trident. We got in gold to get dice or die trying. And then we have the SB with the skull infused in it. Also, every single item, you got the hoodies, shirts, and shorts come with a custom tag.
There it is, geez.
And we also got the shorts coming in white. Boys.
These white ones are, like, actually fucking disgusting.
They're gonna sell out, one of one. You better sure you fucking cop it.
Let me see this camera real quick.
Look at this camera.
Guys, look how dripped out this man is right now.
She's the fit for today.
I can't get over this. I can't get over that. Like, this thing is fucking disgusting.
I think it's tied between the back of this shirt and then the shorts for like my favorite thing on the whole drop. Yeah. I think that's, those two items are my favorite. Even though the hoodie is fucked, those two are my favorite.
The shirt and shorts combo.
Yeah, I like the shirt.
Absolutely insane.
And look at this. Perfect. I mean, anyone that copped these joggers, I mean, the outfits are just endless. They're endless. Infinite
look at
potential.
This. You copped these joggers.
If you copped these
the
joggers.
Perfect.
And the hoodies.
Figure it out, boys.
Yeah,
all the future potential. Ones are going to be matching. Trust.
And, you know, like I said, these can never get them again. These can never get again. This is, you're never going to be able to get this again. Never going to get that again. The stringer.
Figure it out. Once it's gone. Well,
once it's gone, it's
figure it out.
Gone.
And also, for reference, guys, we all are rocking large shorts, large tanks. Justin's rocking a double X hoodie.
If you're taller, whatever.
If you're taller, definitely want to size up.
Size up. I'm rocking an XL hoodie, so is Justice. And I'm rocking a 2X in the shirt for a really good pump cover, I think.
I'm rocking an XL, personally.
Whatever, I weigh 220, so I gotta get the double X going. But I'm also gonna mock up this shirt a little bit, just crop it, make it a little bit shorter because it's just a little bit long, and I'm gonna leave the neck at the moment. I'm gonna see how I like it, because I do, G-Man pointed it out, the back just looks pretty insane with the whole neck on it, so. But yeah, guys, go to Target or anything like that and get one of these, box cutter, whatever you wanna call it. This is what I use to cut all my shirts, so. A bulk art, boys, figure it out. So. This is it right here. You're gonna make it nice and even. I do this with every t-shirt I get, whether it's Aesthetic Boys, Young LA, or anything just from a store, I always cut them. I always at least crop them. Put the thing down. This shirt, I think we're just gonna go money, and then just go try to keep it as straight as possible. I kind of, that was actually not too bad. Now let's see, you guys are about to see the little difference now. Here is the after. So this is what we're gonna be rocking with. This is just how I make every single t-shirt, just get a nice little crop.
Hey, look at that whole fit, bro. Like if anyone has these joggers, I'm sorry, but you need to get this shirt, okay? Because those two together, like, it's actually a disgusting combo.
These joggers with this.
Because you're getting so much of like the loud shit up front for pants, but when you turn around, you're getting so much loud shit on the fucking shirt. It's like a yin yang.
Right in
front read
of
between
face.
The lines. This it's could be heaven. Figure
fucking,
it.
Everyone that has this shirt, you just know that they understand life and how it works because you see them rocking. It's like, oh, he's Aesthetic Boy. He gets it. So figure it out, boys. Limited edition. Never coming back.
Think about
code
it.
Alpha too, because I'm sick. I have COVID. If you guys want to help me get the vaccine, use code Alpha. Appreciate it.
Run it up, boys, please. He's going for a blinker. Pre-gym, come on, you have to, you're in it, bro.
In it.
Stay in it. Stay in it.
Yikes.
Oh my gosh.
It's like, it's about to disappear, and then it'll go back to that, and right when I'm about to cough, gone.
Not real.
And I'll put an echo on it.
Figure it out. This is the best pretty known to mankind. Dialed. Sour watermelon. About to go almost a full scoop of that. Gonna bless him up. Hey, if you guys want some pre-workout, just go ahead and run up code Static Boys on Vision. Now, we're going to mix that with...
I want you to go ahead and fucking wake up and put that daily creatine in there, baby.
All right, don't skip your creatine. I put creatine in my shake this morning, so I'm good off that. But we're also going to mix it with the Forbidden Pre. Get that really high stem, just get stemmed out. Have a nice little combo of the Dialed and the Forbidden. And well, figure it out.
Fuck it, I'm going with the Riser Fit Stack today.
And then we're also going to top it off with a little bit of Pump Potion, boys. So we're going to go the ultimate stack. Insane pump coming. Now, boys, also be ready, too, because summertime, guys... We have a brand new Static Boys pre-workout coming your way. Stay tuned for that.
I'm going with Brad, kick the sheets, baby. Brad, if you're watching this, and what you're not, you're a legend. and also, Brad, I'm glad you figured it out.
Yeah. So glad.
What does that mean?
Brad woke up.
You don't know.
Brad woke up. He basically kicked the fucking sheets.
Figure it.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Try doing Disney Plus. Can you put that on the screen somewhere?
Now I'm gonna have to try to do it.
Alright. I'm Justin Martini, and you're watching Aesthetic Boys. Hey guys, this is all the orders going out to the Aesthetic Boys athletes. If there's any athletes that are watching this video, and well, probably none of you guys are, but if you are, your packages is on the way. Oh shit, I actually squeaked. Hey, Rebetta. All right, gents. Look who the fuck is in town. He just moved officially, new to Houston, and the Static Boys athlete.
Jeremy. Yo. Jeez. Are y'all kidding me? Are you kidding me? Are you actually kidding me, bro?
About to be next level. Jermaine's a legend, boys. He also just moved to Houston. So you're gonna be seeing a lot of Jermaine in my videos and the Static Boy videos, everything. He's a day one, bro. He's a fucking legend. We're gonna see how a 405 feels, but definitely gonna run this PR. Gotta get in it. This is the ultimate fit. The white shorts and the hoodie. The white compliment, the gold.
Figure it out, baby. Figure it the fuck out. I'm pissed. I forgot my headphones today. I've been playing the most NPC shit ever.
Good. No belt either, but when for this next set, I'm definitely slapping on a belt. Gonna make me brace harder, get tighter, and I think we're just gonna go ham on this top set, go all out. All right, guys, so I just hit 405. I just had to take a fat shit too, so I'm recollecting myself, figuring it out. Got five plates on. This is the PR song right now. Caltech Awaken. This shit, bro, it like peaked. It sends this like insane chills all throughout my body. It actually feels like it boosts my test. So. I haven't made my belt any bigger, I think, since I started my bulk. Bro, now, like, I can barely get the first loop, like, no shirt, like, I gotta loosen this up ASAP. I actually hope I can brace, bro. Alright. I think I can do it. This is so tight. It already feels like it's like latched, but it's not. I hope I can like breathe and brace properly. So we're about to see what happens. There's a chance I might throw up because it's so tight mid-set. I don't know what's about to happen, but I'm gonna try and figure this out. But the bulk's getting to me now.
So you've done a Houston summer either.
Yeah. All right, that's a PR. Most before was 5. That was 7, I think. And I'm actually not gonna lie. Right when I finished that set, damn, bro. I about fucking yacked, bro.
How many was that?
7. That belt was so tight, I need to loosen it. Oh, dude. Hey, PR, baby. Says Static Boy Energy. 420, be ready. Figure it out.
I'm taking fat shit, now it's time for me to go, so I'm excited.
If you guys do, you know, high reps on deadlifts, you know how taxing that is. It feels like I'm just about to, like, collapse, bro. But I got a couple more sips of my pre left. I'm gonna finish that when we're done. I'm gonna eat a couple more strips, get some quick carbs in the system. We're gonna be refueled up, we're gonna be chilling. We're gonna murder this workout, back and shoulders. Now, Justice is just gonna toy around with his weight, so. He reps out like 6 plates for probably as many as I just did on that. Dude's strong as fuck. Because our chest is so tight still, bro, from yesterday. So it was probably just like a...
That didn't feel good at all.
This is documentation.
Right. So I go to a smoke shop and I get these sour strips that are edibles, you know, great for relaxation and everything and for recovery. If you take a lot, though, you're going to green out and feel like you're dying. They're 500 milligrams a strip. I take about 100 at a time, maybe 200 if I'm feeling it. 200 is like greening out, right? I'm telling Justin, if this is our best drop ever on 420 and you guys murder it, because it's 420, figure it out, and we go absolutely crazy, that night I'm eating a full strip.
He's gonna green out to everyone. This is the requirement. We need to sell 420 shorts, bro.
And the first day, and
over
then I'll do it.
420 shorts, and then we're gonna document and film him greening out and taking a full strip worth of 500 milligrams.
And if we sell over 500 shorts, actually, if we sell over, yeah, somewhere around there in the first day, I'll definitely take a full strip, maybe even 2. Not. I'll take 1 though. This is the shake, this is the handshake.
Fun fact, I've actually never seen Joey green out before, so like, please guys, sell. We need to get over 420 shorts so I can watch him green out.
But here's what happens, once you figure it out, it's all mental, you can never green out. Justice is on his MJ grind right now. He's doing the flu game. He feels like shit. And he's still pulling heavy weight. So, W comment for Justice right now. He's training while he's sick. The real pump begins. The infinite pump caps. If you guys have never tried these, I highly recommend it. It is truly the best pump of your life. You want any of these, bro?
Sure.
Take some pump caps.
I'll take some pump caps. Thank you so much. See the vision.
But figure it out. You look at these ingredients, they actually shit on any other pump product out of any other supplement company. And I'm not saying that because I'm biased. It's just ingredient based. These actually give you the best pump of your life. So we're going to, the serving's 4, but we're only going to take 3 because I already have a lot of pre in my system. So I don't want to overdo it with the pump. About to pop these, get dialed in. We're about to get a sick pump. So let's go, baby. And, probably film a little bit, some raw stuff during the workout, especially on the shoulders, show you guys how to really train hard and go to failure.
I just hit that PR and I think that's all my body had left in it, so I think I'm just gonna meditate for the next 24 hours and then hopefully I recover. So wish me luck.
Good luck. You got it.
Alright guys, about to run some rear delts. This is one of the, I love like starting with rear delts because they're my lacking point and I want to grow them the most. So I'm running these dumbbell rows right here. We're gonna go to absolute failure. We're gonna keep this set raw. I'm just gonna go as pretty much as many reps as possible. We'll get big squeezes, big contraction, insane pump, and I'm just gonna go to failure, and you're gonna see how I train. We're gonna do like 2 more sets just like that. Absolute failure. I literally cannot pull anymore. And also if you noticed, I put my thumbs like over it. Because if I did it like this, it would put a little bit more tension on my forearms. Thumbs over, it's like all rear delts. Pull through with your elbows. I'm telling you, it's gonna be the nastiest rear delt pump of your life. All right, guys, so finishing up the workout. The pump's pretty nasty. Gym three, I always sweat bullets in here. Here's just a little reality check for you guys. This is the bulk. Look, I'm 222 pounds in the morning, about 225 pounds at night. This is how I look, just not flexing. Look, this is ultimate relaxation. Got a little bit of the bulk gut. It's gonna happen, guys. I'm up almost 40 pounds. But here's, if you flex a little bit, I don't look too bad. Yeah, guys, this is just pretty much an honest update. I feel really good. Mentally and physically, this is the best I've ever felt on the bulk. I'm gonna keep crushing my workout, but then I wanna talk to you guys a little bit about just mental health with the bulk and kind of how to approach that situation in the best way possible. But always trust the bulk, the process will be worth it. Sometimes it's a little rough putting on the weight, but I promise you, when you get shredded, it just makes everything so much better and it makes the bulk worth it. And I promise you, if you're bulking right now, it's gonna pay off. All right, guys, so the workout's done. Just finished up back and shoulders. It was a nasty workout. Did a lot of rear delts today, just a little bit of back, because after those deadlifts, my body was wrecked. It just puts so much pressure like on your central nervous system, especially just repping out deadlifts, like anything over like 3 reps on deadlifts or squats or anything like that. It is a lot on the body. But yeah, guys, as you saw in that last clip, I'm not looking too bad on the bulk. Again, I'm in the 220 range, so I'm heavy. Like I tapped out on my last bulk at like 210 because I felt like shit and I looked like shit, at least I thought I did. This bulk go around though, I do think I'm leaner. My diet's been much, much better this bulk, as you guys have seen, like in my full day of eatings. But I just want to say, like, don't be afraid to bulk, because I know there's a lot of fitness influencers out there that just stay shredded like 24/7, which I don't have a problem with. But it also, these guys that stay shredded 24/7 have very, very good genetics that not everyone has. They have, like, you know, some have 1 in a billion genetics, some have 1 out of 100 million genetics, whatever it may be. They're able to stay lean and pack on a little bit of size and still look great. The average person, if you stay lean, your physique's really not gonna get that good and you're not gonna put on that much muscle. It's just a lot of people don't have those genetics or those insertions like some of these influencers have that stay shredded all the time. So I just wanna give you guys, just trust me when I say the bulk will pay off. I started this bulk at 183 pounds and just like looking back at when I started, like looking at how fucking shredded my face was, how shredded my core was, the veins, the jawline, everything. It's like, yeah, I want that forever. But if I maintain that, I mean, yeah, my physique could get decently better in maybe like a year of maintaining, but nothing too crazy. But actually taking the proper time to bulk, I'm approaching now, I'm at the 9-month part of my bulk. So this has been a long one. My previous bulk was 9 months. This one's gonna be a little bit longer. Like I said, I started at 183, 184, and I'm 222, 223 pounds in the morning. So I'm up now almost 40 pounds. And I really don't feel like that bad. Like, it kind of sucks having a little bit of the bulk gut, like my, especially in that like stomach area, because sometimes like I can't even wear like super tight tanks or anything anymore, just because like my stomach kind of pokes out a little bit. It can be kind of annoying sometimes on the bulk. But the other thing, like, you just can't think too much about it, because it's not like you're getting fat. Like, you're literally bulking, you're eating a lot of food to put on the necessary size that you need to cut down and get shredded to literally level up your physique. And like I said too, I've been bulking for 9 months. I'm probably gonna tap out in about 6 to 8 weeks. So I'll be approaching like 10, 11 months of a bulk. You guys that bulk should never bulk any less than honestly 6 months. Because I've seen some people, they bulk for like 3 months, put on 15, 20 pounds. You know, it's a little more than a pound a week. In 3 months, that 15 to 20 pounds is a lot of water weight and things like that. Like, it's not, you didn't actually put on that much muscle. You can't put on that much muscle in just a few months of bulking unless you're running gear. But if you just bulk for like 2 or 3 months, put on 15 pounds and get shredded again, I promise you, your physique will look the exact same it did when you first started. So if you're watching this and you're bulking, please take your bulk serious and bulk for at least 6 months. That is the bare minimum, but I would recommend longer. I really don't know too many people in the industry that have truly bulked like hard. I've recently seen, I think Max Taylor actually did a pretty good bulk, so shout out to him for actually trusting the process. And then another good buddy of mine, Skyler. That man has actually been a huge inspiration to me, so shout out to him. He has been on a bulk now. He's natural, he looks insane, he looks amazing. He's been on a bulk, I think, bro, for like fucking a year and a half. This kid's transformation has been insane. He kind of, you know, he had the pretty boy look, he was like 175 pounds, looked amazing. This dude is, last time I checked, he was 242 pounds, and he's my height. He looks phenomenal. Obviously, he's not that lean. Like, he doesn't really have many abs or anything like that, but he's trusting the process. So I give my utmost respect to him because he is actually bulking. And this dude's physique, when he cuts, is going to be life-changing. And another thing too, like, why I think I see some influencers don't bulk, and I see it on my page as well. When I'm like peak bulk, the engagement just goes down. Like, the true fans will stay and appreciate the bulk and everything, but a lot of people, like, they don't really care to engage with your shit because you don't look, you're not shredded and you're not super aesthetic anymore. You just can't think too much about that. Like, I've even had some people reach out to me saying, like, I'm literally cutting because my social media is down. Like, you can't think like that. Like, yeah, it kind of sucks. My socials have been down the last couple months specifically because I'm at like the peak bulk and not many people are too engaged with it. But you can't let the social media and what everyone think about you stop you from bulking. Because if you actually want to bulk and put on the size, you can brush all that shit to the side. Like, I don't give a fuck that my likes are down, my engagement down, whatever it is, because I'm doing what's best for me. I'm not just gonna cut because, oh my God, my socials are down, I gotta cut. I don't think like that, and you can't think like that. Just take the proper time, go on a good bulk, and just keep that good mentality throughout the bulk. Like, you're eating, you're putting on size, you're putting on, yeah, you're gonna put on fat, but you're getting fucking huge. You're putting on size, you're gaining strength, all this shit, you're hitting PRs. Just soak up the moment and truly enjoy the bulk process because it is awesome. It's a good excuse to eat a lot of food, a good excuse to hit PRs, get super strong, get big, and put on and just grow as much as possible. Because guys, when you cut after going on a bulk for so long, not only are you gonna feel so good about yourself because you said, yeah, fuck yeah, I took about a year off to bulk to build the physique that I wanted. And another person that just came to mind that goes on, that actually went on a big boy bulk, and then he blew up even more. He was already in this, and his name was already big in the industry. But Zach Jennings, this kid fucking bulks, man. And I respect him so much for it because he puts on a lot of fucking size in the off season and it pays off because when this dude gets shredded, he looks unbelievable. So just truly just trust the process, go on a bulk. I know summer's coming up and you guys probably want to get shredded. If you want to get shredded, that's fine. But if you're still bulking right now and you want to bulk through summer, I would definitely recommend it. My last summer, I bulked through summer. So now this summer, I'm going to get shredded for summer because I don't want to have like two summers back to back of being bulked up. But yeah, guys, just if you're watching this, please take the time to bulk and enjoy the process. It's a lot of fun. And yeah. Yeah, boys, I'm just sitting on this tree at Alphaland. This is actually a vibe. It's very, very comfy. I'm digging it. But yeah, guys, be ready for this drop. We're very, very excited for this. Get diced or die trying, baby. That's the slogan for prep. The shirt, break free. This is Justin's tattoo. It's a beautiful meaning. And then the hoodie is awesome, guys. I'm very, very excited for this drop. And as you guys know, the hoodie, it's literally right here on my leg. And I got this tattoo because this was a statue at my college of just Atlas holding up the world. I thought it was just a beautiful piece of art. So I was like, might as well just get it on my leg. Now we're putting it on a hoodie. And as you guys see on the hoodie, it says the world is yours, guys. Everything that you want to do in this world, you can do. Manifest it, always believe, have that burning desire in everything that you do, and everything that you could possibly want in this life will come to fruition with limitless desire. Your potential is infinite, guys. The world is yours, you can do anything you want in this world. So be ready, guys. We do not have a time yet for the drop, but it will be dropping on 420, so be ready. It's about 2 weeks out from when you see this video. We're super, super excited. We don't have a quantity count yet, but be ready for that. They're gonna be very, very limited. And as a reminder, as all of you guys know, every single drop is one of one because you're one of one, bro. You're unique in your own way. Every single drop is one of one. You get one chance to cop it, and if you don't, it's never coming back and you're never gonna get it. And as you guys saw too, you can mix and match our old and new drops together. And I just want to say too, thank you for all the support on Aesthetic Boys. You guys have been killing it. We're super excited. We're introducing the shorts for the first time, baby. Perfect for summer. We got the mesh shorts. G-Man's rocking the shorts, baby. He's rocking.
We're matching today.
Let's give one more look real quick at the back of this shirt, bro.
Because that is beautiful, dude. And as you guys, if you guys can see too, this Aesthetic Boys,
I was just gonna say, it's
is like
bubble
it's a
letter.
Puff print, bro. It is so insane. Like, look at the detail. I'm super excited for this.
And this is also too, guys, the quality on this drop is the best we've ever had. We have a very, very good manufacturer now. The t-shirt quality is amazing, the stringer, the shorts, the hoodie, everything is perfect. And the hoodie too, if you guys got the our last hoodie in the Japanese drop, This new hoodie is a little bit lighter weight, so it's very, very good for like the spring and summer vibes. It's not gonna be too toasty. This is gonna be a great just little pump cover hoodie to rock. But yeah, guys, if you enjoyed that video, please smash that like button and subscribe and comment down below kind of some videos you wanna see going forward. I got some ideas kind of flowing for like the next video. But yeah, boys, I really appreciate the love and support. Be ready, static board drop 420. All right, guys, gonna be very limited stock. Again, one of one, because you're one of one. Every drop is special because you're very special. You're a legend if you're watching this. And yeah, guys, if you enjoyed the video, again, smash that like button and subscribe. I will see you in the next one. Peace.